Okay, guys, moving on to the map. The map itself is 8 by 8 square kilometers, represented by those big square thingos, not thingos, grids. So there's a lot of locations, there's a lot of names. Just before I go any further, you've got to remember, just because there's a name on it doesn't mean that's where you want to go. There's a lot of named places that are rubbish, and there's a lot of unnamed places that aren't rubbish. So this map, this is where you spawn. This nice little petite red circle in the corner. I'm pretty sure, yeah, there's invisible covering that island, so don't try and go to it thinking you can pick some shit off the table or where people let it. But it's just like a nice little fun fact knowing it's in the same vicinity. And moving on, these are all the, I don't want to say noob too much, although this is a beginner guide. This is where the main hotspots, I like to call them, are, because there's good high risk, high reward. Not high risk, high reward. A lot of players, a lot of good loot, flock to these spots. So obviously you've got the main towns like Yazamaya, Pachinki, Rozhok, which is, I tend not to go to Rozhok, but it is probably hot. Georgepol is really good in my opinion because it's so massive. Primorsky, and then obviously military base, Nova. Nova's extremely good. I've circled these places because they're pretty much guaranteed to get you level 3 gear with assault rifles, with 4x as sniper rifles, attachments. They're just, it's, that's where the party's at. But if you go to, if you pick any to land at any of these places and others, which I'll go into a bit further in a second, expect to have to kill one or two people to get what you want. So what I haven't, obviously, you guys might be like, what the hell, why is a bunker in here? What about gun range? Oh, what about the sunken town? Blah, blah, blah. There's a cluster of houses here. Why is it Malta? These are the ones where you should go when you're not totally familiar with the game. The gun range can be confusing, and it's pretty crap in my opinion. The bunker is highly contested pretty much every game, and unless you've got good quarter combat, because you can't avoid people. Unless you grab a gun and then leave straight away, you cannot loot the bunker without having to fight one or two guys. And these guys, they go to the bunker for a reason. They don't go because they're shit aim. Like, I love the bunker, as you'll see in the upcoming clips, but yeah, not for everyone. These are the spots where you want to go, my favorite being Nova and Georgepol, and I actually like the military base a lot. So this is like a standard plane pathing. Obviously it comes down maybe close to the island, and it goes kind of like throughout the middle of the place. Obviously they're not all like this. Obviously there's a lot of variation where each plane can land or go, but that's the general that's the general pathing. And you might think, obviously, oh, I'll go to these hotspots, they're close, it's a quick little drop, there's nice, there's a lot of variety. But if you think about it, a lot of players are going to see those hotspots, and a lot of players are going to think, huh, that's 6 hotspots for 100 players. Obviously, like, a bunch of players won't go for those, but a lot will. You'll have 4 people in bunker, maybe 5. This is saying solo games, squads probably more. The crater will be covered, Lepovka, Yazamaya, and there's nothing wrong with going to those ones, but you're guaranteed 99% chance, unless you get lucky or you're just really pacifist, that you will encounter another player, and they will probably have a shotgun, and you probably will have a shotgun as well, and they'll just be quicker, as in my case a lot. So even though they seem like the obvious ones, we don't actually want to go to those ones. The ones we want to go to are actually the ones further away. You might be thinking, what the fuck? That's pretty retarded. But there's a lot of method behind the retardation behind that, and it's the fact that I'm teaching you a guide to get high ranking, top 10, top 30, top 20, top 10, get some kills, be in a really good position. All of these places, especially Nova, have crap load of car spawns. Malta power plant's got like 3. Georgepol's got a bunch. And then there's some up north as well near 70. But basically, you want to go to these ones because there's a low chance of players. And if you can get 3 minutes, let's say you land, you have to either run a bit, swim a bit, drive a bit, or maybe you're really good with a parachute and you can make it all the way there. You get uncontested, like 3 to 5 minutes of free loot of a hotspot. And now I'm talking level 3 everything. I'm talking snipers, cars, ARs, everything that will set you up to increase your statistics of winning the game. Because this game's statistics. It's skill, but it's statistics as well. You got to use the stats in your favor. You got to use chance. So, but yeah, always for this situation, I would probably aim for Malta or Nova, maybe even Georgia Pole. But obviously I'm not it's not always going to be no one there. I'm just saying, using stats, there is a lower chance you'll encounter players or a great number of players if you go to these spots. And you might be thinking, they're kind of out the way though. Like, what about the circle? Like I said, the circle's random. You could end up totally in the middle of the circle if you get lucky, or if not, there's car spawns in all of those, in pretty much in every hotspot. Yeah, there are car spawns in every single hotspot, and you take those. So that's it for maps. That's it for where you should drop. Obviously, you guys would have your own ones, like hospital, maybe yeah, bunker. Like I said before, maybe the clusters on the coast. There's a bunch of clusters of nice houses that have level 3 gear. But I'm just saying, as a beginner who wants clear, concise places to go, these are the best places that guaranteed you will pick up an AR, like a minimum level 2 gear as well. Minimum level 2.